Julian Loss, John Hugo's Carl Moran. This is a great example of how to get accepted to the Rump Session, yeah? When your title is something, something, something chickens. Guaranteed accept. So let's hear the talk on something, something, something chickens.
Okay, so the title of the talk is actually The Best of Both Worlds, Byzantine Agreement Protocols for, but not limited to, chickens. Okay, so this is joint work with Tom Moran. Okay, so suppose we are in the following setting. We have this large road here in the middle, and on the right-hand side, we have old MacDonald's crypto farm. And so on this crypto farm, we have a lot of different crypto animals. We have the drove of secret-sharing sheep. We also have the predicate encryption pony, and there are also a lot of free-roaming crypto chickens. And on the left-hand side, we have the pen where the chickens sleep. So now consider the classical problem from crypto slash distributed computing. The chickens are trying to decide whether they want to get from the left side of the street to the right side of the street or vice versa. But the problem now is that birds of a feather always flock together. So this means that the chickens either will all cross the street at the same time or none of them will cross. And so the question is, how can the chickens ensure that they will all cross the street at the same time? So, being crypto chickens, they have actually come up with a very elaborate solution for this problem, which is to run a protocol for Byzantine agreement. You just heard about this in the previous talk. Okay, so this agreement will ensure that all of the chickens, you know, cross the road at the same time, and for the sake of this talk, assume that the chickens are connected via some gossiping network. And all of this, of course, would be easy, but the problem now is that you have malicious ducks which pose as chickens and try to prevent agreement for this Byzantine agreement protocol. And the chickens want to ensure that if there is some minority of malicious ducks posing as chickens, they can still achieve this agreement. And so far, they've come up with two solutions. Okay, and so for the remainder of the talk, like, let n be the number of chickens. So the first type of solution uses synchronized clocks, okay? And this means that the chickens will proceed in a lockstep type of fashion, and you know, they will proceed in synchronized rounds, and in this way, they can actually tolerate up to n half malicious ducks posing as chickens, and they can still achieve agreement. Okay, but the problem is that typically chickens don't own watches. So this means that the only means of synchronization that is available to the chickens is the crow of the rooster at the beginning of each day. And because of this, actually every synchronous round that the chickens will use in this protocol will actually have the length of an entire day. Okay, so typically these synchronous protocols, they, even in the constant round case, you know, have maybe 20 rounds or something like this. So this means that just across the street, the chickens will need 20 days to agree just to cross the street or not to cross the street. And this is not really a good solution. So fortunately, the chickens have also come up with another type of solution, which can do without synchronization. Okay, and if the gossiping network is fast, then actually this type of solution, this asynchronous type of solution, will guarantee a very, very fast agreement. But on the downside, this type of protocol can only tolerate third ducks. Okay, so now the chickens have actually a very, very natural question, which is, can we come up with a protocol which is both fast and also robust? Okay, and being crypto chickens, of course, they're also interested in whether this protocol is actually optimal. And so if you're also interested in this question, then please check out our ePrint paper, which is titled Combining Asynchronous and Synchronous Byzantine Agreement, The Best of Both Worlds. At the bottom you have the short URL. And I would like to conclude with an open question, which is, why did the chickens try to cross the road in the first place? They could have just stayed in the pen. Thank you very much for listening.